Hi, I'm Roland Mesa. On Filmmakers Showcase today, we're featuring the works of four students in two of the most renowned high schools in the city as far as film programs and film teaching is concerned. To my right, we have Tom Perkowitz and Don Hatterline, who are both from Loyola Academy High School in Wilmette, Illinois. And to my left, Dan LeBeau and Rich Varnes, who are from Oak Park High School. Tom and Don, you guys didn't take the same class together, I understand, as Dan and Rich did. Don, you're a senior, right? What do you...
I just graduated.
What class was this for that you...
This is for an elective filmmaking class. There was no requirement to take it.
Okay.
It was basically, we studied the history of filmmaking, and then towards the second quarter, we started making our own films.
Mm-hmm. Well, did you have to do this in a group with other people in the class? Did they have to work on it?
That was left option, but I decided to take it on my own.
Do it on your own.
Yeah, and I taught my crew, myself, my buddies, mm-hmm. you know, what to do, and my actors and the talents were all my own appointments. You know.
Okay, so you did a dramatic film now. How did you find the talent?
Well, it's usually the talent is one of my best friends, and we just, we had like a common wavelength.
Always ends up.
Yeah, no, but I knew that, you know, I could tell him something and have him act out what I wanted, and I had no problem with that, you know, relating that with him. So the rest of the people were just kind of around at the time to fill in spaces.
Did it take you a long time to shoot, or?
No, actually, we had a little trouble, though. We had a camera breakdown on us on the first day. So we were, you know, we were lucky because the outdoor scenes, weather didn't change over 24 hours. So there's like, you know, two different days in some of the scenes. And then some of the subjective shots were done without anyone else around. The next day, I just took the car out myself and was shooting through the window and stuff. So,
Did you have a camera of your own, or did the school provide you with one? Or?
Yeah, well, they provided us with one, but to get a animation, I had to use our own camera.
For the single frame.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Now your film is called One Way Out, right?
Yeah.
Can you describe it a little, introduce it?
Well, the film basically is it's on suicide, and. You know, I got the idea when I, you know, read in Time magazine that, you know, the North Shore is, you know, the highest suicide rate in the country. And it really blew me away, you know, thinking that, you know, we're top 1.5% of the nation and stuff. And here we got, you know, the suicide rate like that. So I gave it a lot of thought and thinking of what would go behind, you know, psychology in someone's mind, you know, to commit suicide.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, in an adolescent's life, you know, you really aren't faced with too many problems.
Now you're using Who music too, I understand.
Yeah.
As a background, or rather, to go with it. Why'd you pick the Who?
Because I love them. I'm nuts about the Who. Plus, the Who is traditionally dealt with adolescents and their problems.
Teenage aliation, things like
that. Oh, sure. Like their whole Quadrophenia album was again dealing with, you know, frustrations with drugs, with the breaking out into the real world from your sheltered life with the family.
Okay. Before we give out too much information on this film, let's take a look at it then. This is One Way Out, Don Hatterline.
Thank you.
That's a very powerful type of movie as far as emotions go. What reactions were you getting to people you showed it to? Like teachers or family?
Yeah,
you know?
A lot of them are, depressing. Oh, no, it's not depressing. You know, I go, it's real. It's happening. It's not depressing.
Mm-hmm. You know? How about your classmates? Well, in specific, like your teachers, your classmates, what were they saying?
The teacher liked it. She commented a lot on the play between black and white and color, as in like what's real and not real. You know, and she really enjoyed that. A lot of my friends, they didn't know what to think at first. You know, they didn't know if I was serious. You know, and they're like, "Is this supposed to be funny? Is there really a message here?"
Right.
Like, just take it for what you want to take it for. You know. Mixed. It was mixed.
Mixed.
Yeah. Some people thought it was really funny too. I mean, I had people laughing through the whole thing.
That's probably because they knew people in the movie, right?
Yeah. Maybe because of the amateur photography too. You know, but it was neat.
Very interesting. To Loyola guys, Don, you're
going down
out of the school, right?
Yeah, going down to Champaign.
Champaign, right? What are you majoring in?
Communications, I'm going to study. Maybe some psychology, too. But I don't know if I'm going to really pursue my film. you know, making. I may.
You're also in a band, so.
Yeah, that's a real big, you know, consideration for me now. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're doing a tape. I think I'm going to work on being a musician for a while. Pontius Pilot.
Pontius Pilot?
Yeah, a little religious, huh? It staggers people. I'm a drummer.
You're a drummer for the band?
Yeah, and we're doing a tape over at Universal. And that's my major concern right now, to get that off. And maybe I'll get back into filmmaking.
Yeah,
in time.
You guys doing any TV?
I took a TV course at Skeleton.
I
liked it. I enjoyed working with video. I did enjoy it. The editing and stuff was kind of neat with the video stuff. But again, it's not in the near future. You
know. All right. So film's the word for these high school graduates. And that's it for today on Filmmakers Showcase. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you guys for coming.
Sure.